Hey everybody, thanks for coming out. Please welcome your hosts, Sam Wiles and Dan Benty.
Nothing! Something! Tremendous.
Yes.
Thank you guys for coming out. Everybody, please, real quick, make it loud for So Say We All. Thank you guys very much for coming out. We are very excited.
We are so excited that you came out to the show. Thank you so much.
We'll cut right to the chase. November is the same month as Thanksgiving, if you didn't know. So we did a show about gluttony.
That's right. This show is about our penchant for excess.
Right. I'm going to stick it to him. About doing too much.
Saying too much.
Really saying too much. Using too many words, more so than you would need in a given sentence to convey your thought to whoever you were talking to at the time, more than necessary.
Less is more, we always like to say regularly.
We always say that all the time.
We're not ones to overdo it, Samuel and myself. But this show is more so about a boy leaving all those childish excesses behind and becoming a man.
Yeah, and then that man becoming part of a comedy duo.
And that comedy duo becoming the foremost comedy duo in the greater South Park area.
And then that foremost comedy duo in the greater South Park area then becoming, due to said acclaim, the Batman and Robin of giving sex to ladies and setting an example for America's youth.
And that Batman and Robin of sexing ladies and setting examples for America's youth becomes Charles D. Manwich and the cowboy, drive-time DJs known for their wacky antics, and the first instance of what the FCC describes as the sound of a penis being an affront to the Lord.
Where Charles D. Manwich and the cowboy, drive-time DJs known for their wacky antics, and inventing the first instance of what the FCC calls a penis being an affront to the Lord, become contemplative older gentlemen in a gated community who, over several lunches and games of chess, realize that no amount of free vegetable dip or commercial boat rides or how many Spanish mistresses they have between them can ever bring them back to that same place of joy they felt as young boys. So using that box from the movie Primer, they go back in time to when they were young boys and they find themselves as young boys and they say, hey, young boys, us, dance like no one's watching. And here's the thing, they do dance like no one's watching. And then because they're dancing and no one's watching them, they create a comedy show called New Best Thing every first Wednesday of the month at the Wolfstop.
Again, this show is about not overdoing it.
Not at all. Not even kind of.
Okay? But I do want to mention one thing before we move forward. This show does have a sponsor tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, we are sponsored by the new KFC cheese phone.
Can we get a picture of that cheese phone? The sweet cheese phone? We get a...
Nice.
Good stuff.
Nice.
KFC cheese phone. Hey Dan, you know our generation, the millennials, we're always tweeting and texting.
Ha! Instamatic video, who knows what?
If anything, we millennials love our smartphones.
More than anything.
I know when I'm always doing Facebook on my smartphone, I'm like, why am I not eating melted cheese?
I can really use some cheese.
Ugh. Thank God KFC came out with this new cheese phone.
Typical KFC, having our back when the government can't even figure out a website. That's right.
Thanks, KFC. So if you want to support New Best Thing, go get your ass a cheese phone.
Or... wait until February and get yourself a spicy south of the border.
South of the border means Mexico.
Melted cheese, extra spicy melted cheese phone with a phone!
Cheese phone!
With a phone!
Thank you guys very much! Are you ready to start the show? Your first comedian of the night. We were shocked when we realized that we haven't had him do stand-up yet, and then we also realized it's because he's been in the cast most of the time over 2 years. He's missed maybe one show. We couldn't be more thrilled to have him doing some stand-up. Everybody please make it loud for New Best Thing's very own Nick Crosby!
Thank you. Thank you. I'm gonna put that right there. Hi guys, how are you? Thanks for coming out. You having a good night? Muted response. All right. That's a little weird. All right. Guys, thank you so much for coming out. I am Nick Crosby. I'm no one else, despite who you may think I look like. People always try to tell me, like, who I look like. And whenever they come up to me, they're like, hey, man, you know who you look like? I'm like, I don't know who you're about to say, but I know some offensive shit's about to come out of your mouth right now. It's never anything good. They're never like, hey, you know what you look like? Like a young Ethan Hawke. I'm like, ooh, looking in the mirror at this angle, I can kind of see it. Like, that never happens. This actually happened to me after a show one time. I had a homeless gentleman come up to me after the show, and he said to me, hey, man, you know who you remind me of? You know who you remind me of? Who's that fat comic who died? And I was like, I don't know, all of them? Like, it's not my career goal, get famous and die by 30. Thanks, man, that's good, that's good. I was parking behind a car the other day, and it had a license plate frame that said, San Diego, California, no bad days. So I keyed the shit out of his car, and all I wrote on it was, good to know this won't affect your day. It actually took me 20 minutes to write. I got caught by the cops. I should have been a little bit more direct. I should have been faster. What I wanted to do, same. I recently moved into a second story apartment with my friend, and that's good because I was on a first story apartment earlier, and it got broken into just a couple of weeks ago, like while I was there, which was very weird. Yeah, it was odd because they were trying to break in. I was sleeping. This is the story. It was 5 in the morning, and they were trying to break into the window that's just above where my bed is at 5 in the morning. So I just hear this like banging on the window, and I just woke up. I had been drinking, clearly, the night before, and so I woke up in this drunken stupor and was just like, who's there? And they went, oh shit, someone's in there, let's go. Like, I just found criminals' weakness is basic questions. Like, hey, what time is it? Shit, drop that crowbar, let's split. Come on, we gotta get out of here. They were trying to break in, and they freaked out that I was there, and they left. 5 in the morning, by the way. I don't know. These are either the most tweaked out criminals, or they are some ambitious young upstarts in the criminal industry, guys. They're like, Daddy told me that the early bird gets the stolen Blu-ray player. Guys, let's do this. Anyways, so they broke in. I'm glad that they didn't break in, because I don't know what I'd have actually been able to do had they broken in. Like, I know I might look like I can take care of myself. Like, I might look intimidating because I'm a bigger guy. People are like, no, you don't look intimidating at all. But, like, I'm not, like, the bigness is luxurious. It's not dangerous. Do you understand what I'm saying? Like, you just have to talk to me for 2 minutes, and you see how many hand gestures I use, you'll realize I'm basically just a big dandy. Like, I should have a big white Panama hat and be fanning myself and talking about the last meal I just ate or something. Like, what was I gonna do if they broke in? Just name different types of tea at them until they left? Like, Earl Grey, chamomile, shit, they took the PS3. God damn it. It's gone. I was doing long distance dating. Has anyone here ever done that? I heard an unhappy basically is what I heard from the crowd. I was doing long distance dating. Yeah, that's some awful shit. I would never recommend it. But she lived up in Seattle a while ago when I was dating her. I was getting ready to go see her, and my friend said to me, my female friend down here, she said, hey Nick, you know what you should do, like 2 weeks before you get ready to go see her, you should eat nothing but pineapples and bananas. So when you get up there, your sperm tastes like pineapples and bananas. I was like, I don't see what's wrong with this scenario, let's do it, sign me up. So I did it for like 2 weeks. I ate nothing but pineapples and bananas. And guys, I don't mean to brag or anything, but when I got up there, old Casanova here pretty much spent the entire trip shitting into a toilet. Because pineapples and bananas are fibrous as fuck. Like, why was that your example? Why don't you just tell me to smoke a pack of cigarettes and drink some laxatives before I got on the plane? Thanks. I didn't know that's the way sperm work. Whatever you put in your body is what sperm tastes like. Because if that's the way it works, like, my sperm just tastes like cheeseburgers and Häagen-Dazs. Like, it's delicious. It's like food from the future. It tastes like two things at once. Pick it up when I'm laying down. Guys, I don't know if you follow politics as closely as I do, but I saw something that's pretty funny. If you like jokes, you're going to love this, okay? It was at the Republican convention here in California a couple weeks ago, guys. It was hilarious. What it was, a little bumper sticker that you could get, and it said KFC for Hillary Clinton 2016. Two small breasts, two big thighs, and a left wing. Because the GOP thinks that women should be judged based on how they look and not the quality of their character or ideas. I mean, isn't that funny? There's no hope left for humanity, guys. That's what I'm trying to tell you. It's all going down the drain. I don't know. I think that the end of civilization is here. I think that it's coming, guys. And there's nothing we can do to stop it. We can't pull ourselves out of this tailspin. I say, fuck it. This is my plan. I want to see if any of you are on board with this. I hope some of you are. I say, this is what we do, guys. We collectively pool our money as a nation, or a world, or whatever. We just collectively pool our money for the next 20 years. We just have a giant cocaine party, guys. That's all we do. Just do blow all the time. That way, when the end of the world does come, we've lived enough. You know what I'm saying? We're ready to go out. It's fine. That way, when the four horsemen of the apocalypse come calling, we'd be like, hey there, pale rider, hope you like to party. Took the liberty of cutting you up a couple lines of blow on this Electric Light Orchestra CD case. I haven't slept in the last 17 years. I welcome death, sweet embrace. Anyone? No? Not really getting anything on that one, huh? Silly. Silly little thing. Oh, God, guys, what else do I want to talk to you about, huh? I'm single. Anyone? No takers? I am... Oh, you know what? Fuck that, actually. Let me do this really quickly. I'll talk to you about being single later. Probably not. Okay, but this is... I just wanted to get out of here on this, guys. I'll tell you about this. I don't mean to get too serious or anything on you, but if you guys are drinking, it's a bar, you know, I just wanted to let you know, don't do anything stupid. Like, get super drunk and drive home. But you know when you do get super drunk and you drive home and you get in your car and you realize that the car in front of you is even drunker than you are? Like, he's just kind of pinballing down the street. You're just yelling shit out. You're like, slow down, kids live here, even though you're on the 5 freeway. But you don't really know what's going on. Then finally you're like, you know what, man, I gotta do the responsible thing here. I gotta call this guy in. So you do, and you're like, yeah, hi, I would like to report a drunk driver. What do you mean you need my name and number? All right, it's Nick Crosby. This is 159-0920. And I would like to order two large meat lovers pizzas for only $5.99. All right, guys, that's been my time. Thank you so much. I'm Nick Crosby. Good night.
Take me out for a beer, man. It's been a hell of a week.
Oh, yeah, of course.
First, my girlfriend leaves after that tragic gunfire incident with our cat.
Ouch. Bound to happen.
And then at work, they replaced me with a machine. Thanks, Obama.
Oh, man. What was your job again?
I drove a rickshaw. I'm telling you, cars are a phase. The Shaw? Coming back.
Hey, man, well, this place is going to do you some good. I'm going to introduce you to some drinking buddies of mine. Oh, here they are now. There's Garth and Latrine.
How's it going?
Nice to meet you.
Hello, nice to meet you. Well, you're such a looker.
you.
No one says that.
She's got good taste.
Oh, yes! Fast friends, huh?
Fast friends! You've got such a great aura.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you!
Good.
You guys are so nice already. Turning my week around.
Hey, tell you what. Anybody who's a friend of Dan's, friend of ours. Friend of ours. Yep.
Ah, I feel better.
Hey, everybody!
Hey!
Hey!
Bruce!
How's
Bruce! Going? Bruce, that's a great bartender name.
It's Brewmaster.
Bruce the Brewmaster.
No, seriously. It's Brewmaster.
Okay.
That's the
So, what'll it be, guys?
Well, you know, I think I'm going to go ahead and have the Mud River Wheat Brown Tree Sap IPA.
Oh, excellent. There you are.
And I'll have one of the Cedar Fire Peats. Unwieldy slew of nature words lager.
Absolutely. There you go.
What about you, man? You know, I'll just have a beer.
Yeah.
You guys have a High Life? You guys don't have a High Life? It's a bar. I thought you don't have High Life.
Look, man, this is a craft beer establishment, all right? We don't have any of that mamsy-pamsy bullshit.
I mean... What, were you gonna order pretzels, too?
Fucking pretzels.
That'd be great if you have some.
Oh, seriously, come on. We should have seen this latrine. Come on, look at you. Walking in here with your pants. In your jacket and your not glasses. Ridiculous.
Should have known you'd be drinking piss. Don't take too kindly to your types around here. Best be on your way.
Oh, come on, guys. Give him a break. Seriously, he's never been here before. Come on. Give him a chance. Look. I'll take a Houston Street Double Barrel Mud River Stout. And, this guy will have the same.
Nice.
Yeah. I'm sorry, man. They could be a little intense about the beer.
I was a little scared.
That's weird.
Is that in a pint glass?! Look, man, I'm sorry. We're fresh out of clean glasses, okay?
I will take this cardboard cutout of a giant cat in a top hat and shove it up your ass!
Look, man, I'm sorry, okay?
God. Like I was saying, this is my buddy Nick. He's been having a tough week, but nothing a craft beer can't handle, right?
Oh, boy.
All right, guys, cheers.
Ain't that the truth.
Yeah, sorry. I mean, okay, we just have a passion for craft beer.
I mean, maybe we overreacted a little bit. I mean,
hey, I know what it's like to fly off the handle. Hey, everybody. Cheers to Nick.
Again.
So, what do you guys do for a living?
Well, I don't really do so much as I just, like, am, you know?
And, I make jewelry, ironically.
It's a big market for ironic jewelry?
The jewelry's regular, I just am being ironic.
That's nice.
It might be.
You guys have any kids?
We're trying.
That's great.
If it's a girl, it's going to be Tiffany.
That's nice. That's my mom's name. If it's a boy?
Hitler.
Oh.
We're taking the power back.
Bring it.
Oh, hey! So you guys are running a little low there. Anything else?
You know what? I'll take another. I'm just gonna check this real quick.
You did not just chug a Houston Street Double Mud River Stout IPA.
I chugged it like a champ!
Do you know what chugging a stout does to the integrity of the beer?
No!
Chugging a Houston Street Double Run Mud River Stout is like chugging a Red Rocket Barrel Cascade Aged Hefeweizen, right? Fucking idiot!
Get out!
Seriously, get out! Get out!
Oh my god!
Dan, I don't know what to tell you, man. I think it's best that you go. Go.
What?
Hello? Get me Bud Light. Yes, that John Bud Light. Hello, Mr. Bud Light?
Yes, Nick?
It's worse than we feared. Nerds have ruined beer.
I see.
I'm sorry, sir.
It's not your fault, Nick.
Okay.
Goodbye.
All right. Everybody, we are very excited to have you next to me on the show. He actually gave us this spot 2 years ago.
Yes.
And we couldn't be more excited to have him come down from LA. You can always check him out.
Check him out.
Check him out.
Every Tuesday at Lestat's. Everybody, please make it loud for our good friend, Christian Spicer.
Hey, how's everybody, how am I gonna get comfortable for a little bit? My goal in comedy is to be brought up after a self-inflicted gunshot, so I've done that. That's nothing says get ready for laughs like someone killing themselves. Let them hear it again. Nick and Dan, that was fucking funny. That was good, right? How many people here were like drinking like a fancy beer and they were like, oh shit, and slide this, slid it over. I'll be honest with you guys, I don't know why we're here listening to comedy when we could all be sitting around our smartphones right now listening to a little thing on iTunes Radio I like to call First Play Lady Gaga's Art Pop, because nothing we hear tonight is going to be as good as what's already on Lady Gaga's album Art Pop. So for the rest of my set, internet willing. There it is. Already better than anything I'll say, right? Is that good? I thought you were coming up to dance with me. I am now so disappointed. I was like, it's working, the power of Art Pop is working, but it's not, it's walking the room. She's like, oh, is he really gonna do this for 20? Yes, I am. You're in it, you're feeling it. You're in it, I like it. You're not with me yet, but you will be. Give it a little bit. Good. There it is. I like that. Raise it, sir. You hate me. But you don't hate Gaga. This is good. You know what I mean? Like Miley Cyrus, you want to listen to some bangers? I got a hint. Listen to Art Pop, you guys. Fucking top to bottom. Why do you hate Lady Gaga? She was born this way. It's a really good, it's on iTunes. We could leave right now and go sit in my car and listen to this. Who's with me? Who's coming with me? No show. Every show needs someone that ends the show prematurely by bringing everyone out to their car to listen to Lady Gaga Art Pop, now streaming free on iTunes Radio.
No one's coming with me. That's okay. That's okay.
It's good, man. I don't care about what you think about music. You're wrong. Like, that's the best thing about Spotify, is that I can listen to whatever I want. And yeah, most of it's fucking Lady Gaga. Why? Because this is America. You know what I mean? I don't need to pretend like I like the Beatles, because I don't, because they suck. The Beatles were great in 1942, or whenever the fuck they were in England. Get over it. Lady Gaga is pop now. The Beatles are artistic integrity. No, they aren't. They were Lady Gaga of the 60s. They were trying to fuck chicks and play stadiums. Guess what Lady Gaga's trying to do? Fuck chicks and play stadiums. It's the same thing. I'm so happy to be here, you guys. I'm so happy to be here. Thank you. I'll take it. I'll take a pity applause. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. How much time do I have left? You guys. My daughter just had her first birthday on Monday. That was awesome. I was so excited for her. It's the best. A round of applause. Any parents here? Anyone? Parents? Congratulations. How old is your child? Please still be alive. What?
Six.
Six. Congratulations. That's awesome. Boy or girl?
Girl.
Girl. What's her name?
Ginger.
Oh, is she red-haired?
No.
Because that'd be fucking funny. Here comes Ginger. The Ginger. Gingers are like the one race we're still allowed to make fun of. You know what I mean? Like, if two walked in right now, I could point them out and we'd be like, holy shit, make a wish. And like, we could all do it. But if like two black dudes walked in here, I'd say leave. You know, like, it's totally different. Thank you for the super supportive racist laugh. Ha! That's true! In the mic, too, by the way. I love it. It got picked up on the mic in the booth. It was like, yeah, oh shit. Well, congratulations. That's awesome. My daughter's one. Her name is Estelle. We call her Ellie for short. And I love it. If you're not, be a dad. Not if you're a girl, I'd be weird. But it's the best. People are like, oh, so what do? You're like a comedian and then you take care of your daughter during the day? Is that like what you do? You're like Mr. Mom? Are you like fucking Mr. Mom? No, I'm a dad. We had a word for it. It's like, I'm not Don Draper. I'm not like fucking my secretary and like pretending I don't have kids. I go home, I take care of my daughter because I love her. I'm a fucking dad. Try it for once, you dicks. It's not that... I like that. That was sassy. You're like, tell your man to do the same thing. Get yourself a man, slap those thighs. I like that. I don't know what that was about, but it was confidence and sassy. You and me after the show. I'm married. And it's the best. It really is. It's awesome. I love my daughter so much. I was on the road doing a show when we found out that we were pregnant. My wife called me up and she's like, oh my God, Christian, we're pregnant. And so then the first thing I said is, no, you are. Because apparently, winning an argument about grammar is more important than being happy for my family. And then the next thing that happened is she says we're pregnant, and I'm in my car alone, and I got a boner, you guys, which is like, what? And I've been thinking about it now for a year and 9 months, and the only explanation I can think of is that it was my dick trying to reach up to give me a high five.
We did it!
Hey. You're doing great. You're doing great. It's awesome, though. It's the best. I just don't know why. Like, rationally, it doesn't make sense. I think maybe at year six, it makes a little more sense. But, like, month 0 to 3, are you kidding me? It's the worst. Like, nothing good comes out of a two-month-old. Nothing at all. They're just succubuses. They just drain you of life and energy, and then they take it, and they shit it out. That's all they do with it. But you love them. Like, they smile. My daughter, when she could, like, smile for the first time, and it's called social smiling because they don't really know what they're doing. They just know if they don't do it, you'll kill them. You know what I mean? So they learn really early on to be like, ah. And you love it so much, and it's the most amazing thing, and it just melts my heart. But the thing is, it's like, why? You know what I mean? Like, you guys are all wonderful people. Half of you are smiling right now. If you all died on your way home tonight, I wouldn't give a fuck. You know? Like, that's so weird, but if my daughter died tonight, I'd be a mess. Like, I would probably not get a PlayStation 4 next week. Like, that's how bad it would affect me. But if you guys died, I'd probably be better off, right? Like, less competition for whatever traffic. I'd be like, good, they're dead. I don't like them anyway. It's just so weird, man. Even though I think human babies are really dumb. Right? Like, my daughter's one and she can't even speak English yet. It's like, if you're gonna live in the country, learn the language, bitch. Like, otherwise, go back to Mexico. Go take your jobs. Wherever you're from. Why does it take us so long to do anything? Now she can walk. But, like, a whale is born into water. You know what I mean? Like, a substance it can't breathe. And it swims to the surface, takes a breath, stabs a shark in the gills, splashes its tail, and gets a job at SeaWorld. My baby, if I put her on Fern Street, would be dead in an hour. That's a dumb baby. It's a really dumb fucking baby. It's the worst, man. I've been playing a lot of Batman Arkham Origins on, it's a video game. Do you guys see this, by the way? This is my Twitter profile. Dude, when I saw that was up there for Nick, I was so fucking scared because it says follows you. When Nick was up there, I was like, fuck, I hope I follow whoever that is. How bad would that look? It's like, there's my profile, and it's like, doesn't follow you. Like, hey, can I do your show? What is it? I don't know. I don't follow it. Is that just funny to me? Okay, I'm sorry. Guys, I've been playing a lot of Batman, and it's a great game. It doesn't matter. It's a video game. It's fine. It's whatever. But as I've been playing it, I'm just like, do you think anyone ever told Batman, like, we get it? You know? Like, everything's Bat-something. Like, what? We get it. You know, like someone was just like, what happened to you? Your parents were killed, and a bat flew in your window, and now you're Batman. Fucking get over it. No, why not? Because I gotta save my city. Move. Like, why? You're a billionaire. Why don't you go somewhere else? I hear Metropolis already has a Superman. You know what I mean? Like, why not live there? That's why I can never be a superhero, because I don't give a fuck about my city. I don't even like the baseball team, right? Like, I gotta die to protect the Padres. Nope, not gonna happen. I'm never gonna be the fucking superhero of Riverside, are you kidding me? You show up to that city and it's like, we have a huge meth problem. Oh, fuck. I'm just sneak away. That's why there's never been a superhero of Detroit. The only superhero of Detroit was a human that got killed and got brought back as a robot and was forced to defend the city of Detroit against his will. His name was RoboCop. There's never been any other superhero of Detroit. The closest thing Detroit's had to a superhero after that was Eminem, and all he does is call all the women of Detroit a bitch, and I don't think that's a superpower. I could be wrong. I don't think it's a superpower. I think I have a pretty sweet dick. I didn't appreciate that laugh there. But I do. I think I have a pretty sweet dick. I think it's normal. Like, you always hear people like, my dick's big. When people talk about their dick, all they say is how big it is, right? Man, my dick's 12 inches. My dick, dude, I'm gonna tear that pussy up. I won't. I'll respect it and I'll fit in there nicely. Be very comfortable, I'll hug it, I'll treat it right. When I leave, it'll go back to normal. Like, that's the relationship my dick will have with your pussy. It's a really good dick. I can put on pants, kind of skinny pants if I want to. I don't need to pick a leg. You know what I mean? It's like the pants go on, the dick's in the middle. It's right here. This is my dick right now, you guys. That's sweet. If you had a 12-inch dick, I need to be like over here. That's awkward. That's not comfortable. You always got to pick. I can wear boxer briefs. I'm wearing boxer briefs right now. Do you know where my dick is? The middle of the boxer briefs, where it belongs. That's a good dick. That's a really good dick. The only reason I want a big dick would be a threesome. I've never had a threesome. Probably never will, because I'm not that into it. I know I'm married, whatever. My idea is. But the only reason I think I'd want to have a huge dick is guys are like, I want to fuck two chicks. But why? Because then you're just trying to please two women, and I just think that's like playing a game on hard. You know what I mean? Like, the first time you do it, play it on easy. You know what I mean? Like, maybe use a game genie. Get all the advantages you have. Don't just up the ante and have twice the enemies attacking you at once. That sounds like a bad idea. But if you had a big dick, maybe then it'd be good. Because right now, with my size dick, like, it goes all the way in. You know what I mean? Like, it makes that, like, that fucking... I'm sorry, guys. That, like, that fucking noise when you hear, like, the... Like, that's, like... If I was Houdini, you know, Houdini died because someone punched him in the... He's like, punch me anywhere. And they punched him, and then he bled out, and he drowned, and whatever. Like, if someone came to me, like, I'm gonna punch you. You get to pick the spot. It'd be the spot right above my dick, because that place can take a beating. You know what I mean? Like, it's just like, I feel nothing there. It's just fucking hitting. Whatever that spot is, it's just nothing. And that's a good sized dick, because it's just all the way. I don't need to put on the brakes. I'm like, am I hurting you? It's like, you want it deeper, but this is all I'm giving you. It's all the way in there. And that's a good dick. But if I had a really big dick, then I'd want a threesome, because then you'd be like, careful, and you'd only get like the first 8 inches of it in, and then you need another girl to work like the other four or whatever. And that makes sense because then you're like, yeah, and then you get this little girl like, yeah, and that'd be great, but I don't need that because I have a good dick. That's what I'm saying. I think if I were to have a threesome, I'd want it to be with another guy. No. I don't think that's weird. I think that's the way you want it to be, because it'd be like the best thing ever, right? Because you get to talk about sports. And you get to hang out with your friend and do the thing you both like doing. It's like a guy's dream. You want to come over to my house and watch the game? Yeah. Hey, you want to come over to my house and watch the game and have a sweet orgasm? Yeah. That's the threesome I'm interested in. And you don't have to worry about the girl ruining anything because her mouth's full. You know what I mean? Like this. Shut the fuck up. You just watched a whole sketch of these guys making fun of all of you, and you laughed at all of it. You're like, yeah, we're so pretentious. That's you, you fucking piece of shit. That's me. Look at me. You think I normally have a beard like this? No, I've been growing it out since I knew I was going to do this show. I did a comedy festival in Salt Lake City. I don't know if we have any Mormons here. Say what you want about Mormons, you guys, but they can build one hell of a temple. You know, it's amazing. Like in my downtime, I went to Temple Square, and it's just beautiful, and I was walking around. I mean, I only got to see the outside of it. I didn't get to go on the inside because I'm going to real heaven, but the outside of that temple is amazing. What bothers me about Mormons is that, you might know this, that they spent a lot of money to make sure gays couldn't get married in California back in the day. And they were like, Prop 8 is going to pass and we're not going to let gays get married because we're the Mormon church and fuck gays getting married. Meanwhile, they spent $2 million in the last week of that campaign. Yet for 15 cents a day, some kid in Africa wouldn't die. That's fucked up. You can feed a kid in Africa 15 cents a day. Or you can make sure gays don't get married for $2 million a week. Like, explain that to the kid in Africa. Hey, Matumbe, you're going to starve to death. Why is that? God really doesn't want two dudes to be happy. What? That makes no sense. No, there's dudes. And they put their penises in each other's butts. And they do that anyway, but they want to do that and be married, and I could save like your whole country with the amount of money we're going to spend to make sure that doesn't happen, but I'm not gonna, because they don't pay. Do you understand what I'm saying? Are you dying of famine right now? Matumbe, stay with me. Here's 15 cents. I need to explain this in some way. If gays are allowed to marry, it will affect you. Not at all. If I save your village, gays will be allowed to marry, so I think you can see. I think you agree with me. So I'm going to put this over here. And you're all going to die. But fuck faggots. Am I right? Can you say that? Can you say that, Matumbe? Fuck faggots? Is that right? Can you say that? I'm going to leave this here. Just remember. Fuck faggots.
My name's Christian Spencer. Thanks, guys.
Big game, your wife's nagging you? Is she saying stuff like, take the trash out, and I can't live like this, and sign these papers when you just want to watch the game? Then get out of your man cave, and get your ass down to Callahan's Sports Bar and Sports Grill. We love sports more than you do. We've got all the games on 27 72-inch screens. Wall spaces for pussies. Oh, that's not enough sports? When you walk in, we hand you a Calgary Flames jersey and hat personally autographed by former Jets punter Tom Tupa. While you watch the game, we live tweet statistics at you every 5 seconds. 6 seconds is too gay. We serve every beer in a replica of the Stanley Cup and every cocktail in a porcelain replica of Wilt Chamberlain's dick. Sports. If you got pissed because of all the drinking, our bathroom is sports as hell. All the urinals are filled with hockey pucks, and the hand sanitizer is made with human growth hormone. Get checked, ass hands. Our bathroom attendant is Junior Seau's ghost. Too far. Sports. Your stupid wife left you with the kids on game day? What a bitch. We've got a cage, you can keep them in. You give us 2 kids, and we give those kids nachos. But we give you double nachos. Fuck those kids. Oh, and food? Our food is so fucking sports. Our National Basketball Association nachos are gonna dunk in your ass. Piled high with cheese, ground meat, jalapenos, and our special Vlade Diva Cabole sauce, which are made with 3 ingredients, avocado, sour cream, and Vlade Divac's approval. If you don't eat your food with a hockey stick, we'll call you queer. If you say it's impractical, we don't let you be. Sports.
Tonight's episode of The Fupas is sponsored by 7-Eleven. 7-Eleven, we serve food.
Nervous about confronting him. What if my little lamb chop gets upset?
Look, we put up with this long enough. That young man has got to get his act together. And he's going to do it. My name isn't Frank Fupa.
Oh, Frank! Remember, we agreed to go easy on him. After all, he is very fragile.
Look, enough is enough. I'm not going to have my son walking through life looking like that. Tonight's the night for some change.
What's up, Mom, Dad? Hey.
Oh, honey. How was football practice?
Oh, it was cool. Jeremy showed everyone his dick, so it was super funny.
Oh. Son, when are you going to give that silly football up? It's high time you sat on your ass and watched some TV.
I don't even like TV. It's for people born before 1994.
Oh, honey, those people are nice, too. Why don't you sit down and have some caramel cheesesteak?
If I could just get a glass of water, that'd be all the same to me.
I'm not gonna pussyfoot anymore, all right? Your mother and I have something to say to you. We really feel you need to put on some weight.
The other kids are just gonna be too mean to you.
Guys, if anything, I could stand to...
Oh, you're disgusting. Look at you. I can still see your elbows. You're embarrassing your family.
Every time I see you, I think, God, why can't he be like the rest of us? You know, attractive.
We Fupas are a tough breed. We're a handsome breed. And if you want to be a Fupa, you're going to need to bulk up.
Every time I see you, I think, why, God? Why can you make a pizzone, a perfect pizza calzone combination, but you have to make my son a skinny loser?
I didn't think I was that bad looking, guys. It's...
Oh, honey, don't be delusional. You're terrible looking. I mean, look at all that neck. Oh, my little giraffe.
Let's just start with some dinner, all right? Now, we're having Pop-Tart cheeseburgers and cream of Pepsi. Your mother made her famous pizza calzone. Casserole. It's disgusting. It's good. Eat it. Come on.
No. No! You know what I had for lunch? Grilled chicken. And I feel great. I feel great!
I will grill your ass, young man!
I'd like to see you try.
Frank!
Can't eat this shit anymore. Last week at lunch, drinking sips of cream, my left arm went numb.
It's just the beauty growing inside of you, in your arm!
You know what? I'm not eating any of this. My friend Mike's picking me up. We're gonna go eat some burgers. Veggie burgers!
You make me sick.
Oh, honey. Look, with all this veggie burger talk, it's clear that you have a problem.
Listen, what your mother is trying to tell you is we've got you a feeding stall, all right? Now, it's going to replace your bed, you're going to be strapped in, and at night, you're going to be fed like a baby cow.
My baby's going to live like a veal.
It's for his own good, Margaret.
You're going to use a feeding stall. In 6 months, I'm going to go to college. You guys won't even have to worry about how thin I am.
You will take that feeding stall with you to college. That is your feeding stall.
That's what it's for.
That's Mike.
Come on in, buddy.
Oh.
You're beautiful.
Oh, fuck you guys. I'm just adopting.
Oh, well, we would if we could.
Well, as it just so happens, my family recently died in a tragic hammock accident. I'm up for adoption.
Well, that settles it.
Huh?
Francis, you're out. Mike?
What? Yeah!
You're a fupa now. So, son, how do you like your Pop-Tart cheeseburgers?
With extra cream cheese, of course!
Oh, yes! Fine. I'll go live at the high school, where school lunch is, where pizza's not a veg. See you guys later.
Yeah!
Get out of here, you bony ass little son of a bitch!
Where the only ingredient is the shake.
Thank you guys so much.
We cannot be more excited to have your headliner down tonight. He's one of the funniest guys. I don't know how to finish that sentence. He's super funny and I like him a lot. And I'm so sorry about this intro. Everybody, please make it loud for Brett Weinbach.
Heterosexual man who has gone to a strip club with their male friends. Something to be embarrassed about. You've done it before, right? Something to be embarrassed about.
No.
I'm thinking about getting a boner later tonight. Do you want to come? Come on, man. Let's get some boners. My treat. I love going out with my buddies and getting boners with them. I've actually never been to a strip club before. But if I went to a strip club with you, and we were sitting right next to each other watching a woman take off her clothes, would you be comfortable if I asked you if you had a boner?
No.
But that's just my way of making sure you're having a good time. I'm the one paying for it. I want to make sure I'm getting my money's worth. Your boner's worth my money. I paid for your boner. I want you to enjoy it. And I want to enjoy it with you. Would you be
be comfortable if I was sitting next to you and I had a boner. We're not at a strip club anymore. Let's say we're at a strip club where it's legal to get boners. Would you be comfortable there if I was sitting next to you and I had a boner? He says, sure. Because it's a strip club and it's legal. Now, what if a girl was sitting next to you and she had a boner? Would you be comfortable with that? It's a strip club, so it's legal. What's the biggest boner you've ever had? What if I told you that right now, underneath everybody's chair, there was a boner taped to the bottom of the seat? That's what they did it on Oprah. You guys don't know that I'm Maya Angelou? You guys didn't know that? Tonight you laugh and you learn. You found out Maya Angelou's real identity. It's me. Because I'm half Filipino and half Jewish, a lot of people ask me, who's Filipino? Your mother or your father? My name is Brent Weinbach. You can tell a lot by a person's name, right? What's your name, sir?
John.
John.
Yeah.
What's your last name?
Reynolds.
Reynolds. John Reynolds. John Reynolds. John Reynolds. John Reynolds in the house tonight. John Reynolds, he come from the islands. John Reynolds, big up. One love, Grant Lyon, reggaeton. John Reynolds, reggae beat. Soja citizen, John Reynolds, smoke marijuana. The bigger the bat, the bigger you are, the bigger the jeans, ready while Levi's big jean, yes, I'm living large. John Reynolds is living large. Prakatata. Prakatata, tak, tak. Prakatata, tak, 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 tak. Shaba. So your background is white. I lived in a foreign country for a whole year. And in that time, I was able to learn the language, and I can now speak it fluently whenever I want to. And during that entire time I lived in England, I never had the opportunity to perform stand-up comedy. And so tonight, I would like to perform stand-up comedy for you in English. And even if you don't speak the language, like all foreign comedy, you can still perhaps find humor in my facial expressions. So, like, basically, nice, yeah? And I was doing a game of chess, yeah? I mean, mate, he does a move and he says checkmate. But it's clearly not checkmate, it's just check. So, I was all like, no, mate, it's not checkmate, it's just check. And my mate's all like, yeah, I know, mate, I'm not saying checkmate, I'm saying checkmate. Because, like, use me, mate, yeah? And I was all like, what? That's what I'm trying to tell you, mate. It's not checkmate, mate. It's just check, mate. My mate's all like, yeah, that's what I just said, mate. I said checkmate, mate. And I was all like, what? I was like, what do you mean checkmate, mate? And he's all like, what? Like, I'm not saying checkmate, mate, mate. And I was all like, what? I was like, what do you mean mate, mate, mate? And he's all like, what? And I was all like, what? I was like, it was well confusing. know how to describe it, but this is my impression of it. Yeah, man, we was hanging at the show last night. I see this fine girl walking up that street. She looking good, too. She looked thick, but she looked good, though. You know, she had the ass looking good. She looking fine. I'm thinking to myself, yummy. This is my impression of a disgruntled New Yorker telling an airport shuttle driver which airline he's flying.
Excuse me, sir, what airline are you flying?
JetBlue! This is my impression of a true U.S. patriot telling an airport shuttle driver which airline he's flying.
Excuse me, sir, what airline are you flying?
American! American motherfucker, what the hell kind of airline you think I'm flying? Singapore? I'm proud of my country, I'm proud of my airlines. American. American Airlines. This is my impression of an airport shuttle driver who no longer works for the airport shuttle business, but he now works for Subway sandwiches.
Welcome to Subway. Vita V.
What?
Vita V.
What?
Vita V.
I don't understand what you're saying.
Vite or Vite?
You mean what kind of bread do I want?
Yes, Vite or Vite.
Well, in that case, I want Vite bread. Vite bread, motherfucker. What the hell kind of bread do you think I want? Singapore? I'm proud of my bread. I'm proud of my power. Vite power.
Okay, sir, but what cheese do you want?
American. American Airlines. Two little crabs came across a dick, didn't know what to do, so they pinched it. The dick was a big old message. Two little crabs came across a dick. Didn't know what to do, so they pinched it. And little did they know, the dick was a big old message. That song, you guys like Summer Jams? That country Summer Jam was about two crabs. Real crabs, not the kind of crabs you find in your hair. Real crabs you find on the beach, classic crabs. And they crawled across the sand. What they found was a penis attached to a man. And they didn't know what to do with it. So they pinched it. But the lesson is, they shouldn't have took it for granted and pinched it, because there was a message behind the penis, and they missed out on that message. They took it for granted. It just pinched the penis without learning the message. Let that be a lesson to you all. My name is Maya Angelou. I finally figured out the ultimate comeback. You guys want to know the ultimate comeback? By round of applause, who here wants the ultimate comeback in their life tonight? Tonight, I unveil to you the ultimate comeback. I'd like to bring back to the stage Christian, if you don't mind coming back up. We're gonna he's gonna help me demonstrate this the ultimate comeback tonight. Give him a hand, ladies and gentlemen. Now, look, the truth is, bullying is a serious issue facing today's country, right?
Oh, yeah.
I'm not asking you, I'm asking you. I'm just looking at you. Looking at those baby blue eyes of yours.
I know they're not actually baby blue. Or are they? They're hazel.
They're hazel.
But I feel a baby blue energy behind them. I'm pumped up about that. So bullying is a serious issue facing today's country. And because it is, I took it upon myself to address this issue. And I worked real hard at this. And that's why I finally came to the ultimate comeback, because I feel like it could help you, and it could help me when dealing with bullies. So, you're going to play the bully.
Okay.
When I say action, I want you to say to me, you're a gaylord.
Okay.
Classic. Classic retro-style insult, and you'll say that to me, and in response, I'll use the ultimate comeback on you.
Okay.
All right? And now, I give you the ultimate comeback. Watch. Action.
You're a gaylord.
No, I'm not. You can say that in response to anything. It works. It doesn't matter what he says. You say it, it works. Now, some of you are asking yourselves, that's great. You're also asking, what if you want to be a little more nuanced with your comeback? Fine. Let's take a more specific insult. Let's take the classic insult from 1989, the Micro Machines insult. You guys remember Micro Machines? By round of applause, who remembers Micro Machines? By round of applause, who here remembers the Micro Machine commercials? You remember Micro Machines were miniature cars, smaller than Hot Wheels, micro cars, race cars. And the commercial had a fast-talking man with a mustache wearing a racer's jumpsuit, right? He was talking fast, he had a mustache, tiny cars, little micro race cars, Micro Machines. And I take it a lot of you don't remember the insult, so I'm gonna demonstrate the insult for you first, and then I'll show you the comeback, all right? So this is the insult, all right? Don't take this personally, this is just a demo, all right? Now answer this like you would normally answer this, okay? Just like you normally would answer. Does your penis say Micro Machines on it?
No.
Then it's not the real thing. I didn't make this insult. This is a real insult that bullies use because the commercial went, at the end of the commercial, and said, if it doesn't say Micro Machines, it's not the real thing. That's how the commercial went. But what happens if you answer the other way? Right? Does your penis say Micro Machines on it?
Yes.
I guess you have a small penis then. Either way you answer, you lose. Until tonight. You ready for the comeback? Watch. Action.
Does your penis say Micro Machines on it?
How about you suck it and find out? That's one option. I'd like to now provide you with an alternate option, a more progressive option. This is option number two. Watch. I'm gonna answer yes this time, and so you'll say, I guess you have a small penis then.
Okay.
Okay? Action.
Does your penis say Micro Machines on it?
Yes.
Then I guess you must have a small penis.
It's fast, though. It works. Thank you, Christian. Anyone here have a problem with people being affectionate in public?
Yes.
A couple people? Here's a tip. When a couple is being affectionate in public, the more effective
and progressive way of saying, hey guys, get a room, is to instead say, hey guys, don't get a room. Stay right where you are. Who's excited about smooth jazz? A lot of people don't like smooth jazz. I like smooth jazz because smooth jazz makes everything look sexy. And to demonstrate this point, I'm going to do some stuff on stage. And through the power of smooth jazz, it'll magically become sexy right before your very eyes. All right, let's hit track one. Smooth jazz, it made me sexy. Now, I don't know if anybody noticed, but there was an explosion sound effect at the end of that piece. Did you guys hear it?
Yeah.
Some of you heard it? I didn't put it there. I didn't edit the song and insert an explosion. The song is actually like that. And you can look it up for yourself. It's by Art Porter, Inside Myself, is the name of the track. And it's a real song, it's a real smooth jazz track, a real smooth jazz piece of music. And just to refresh our memory, or in case you missed it the first time, let's hear that part one more time. Let's do track two. Heard of that time, right? To me, the inclusion of an explosion sound effect in the middle of that smooth jazz song, to me it made it funny. To me it made the smooth jazz track funny. It made it comedic, right? And it made me think to myself, perhaps if I started using explosions in my stand-up comedy, then perhaps my jokes might become funnier. Or to some people, funny. So what I'd like to do now is I'd like to perform for you a joke using an explosion sound effect. How about it? Alright, here we go. Because of my boyish looks and small body frame, a lot of people ask me if I even have hair on my chest. Does hair growing only for my nipples count? Are there any churchgoers here tonight? Really? You churchgoer?
No.
No? Sorry. Any churchgoers? No? Here's a tip. if you're ever in church singing a mass, but because it's in Latin, you forget the lyrics, just take out a bag of Doritos and read from the ingredients. This is a bag of Doritos Cool Ranch. It's in the new, bigger size. But any flavor or size will work. Ave Maria. Mono sodium glutamate. Triglyceride, high fructose, corn syrup, dextrose, riboflavin, red 40, may contain nuts. That also works for Hebrew. In case there are any Jewish audience members here tonight, or in case there are any half-Jewish, half-Filipino audience members. This is my impression of a man who is R&B.
Oh, hi, Bobby. Let me take a look at your hair.
What's up, baby? What's your name? What's your name? You like Tevin Campbell? What you got, baby? Come on, give me dough. Come on. Dough, come on, give me dough. Come on. Dough, come on. Come on, dough, come on. Come on, baby, give me dough. Dough, come on. Come on, what you like? You like Keith Sweat? Come on, dough, come on. You like Jodeci? Come on. Dough. I'll get you then, I'll do this myself. Sure, it's all good. What y'all like? Y'all like SWV? ABC, VVD? What y'all like? Y'all like Silk? Y'all like the Above the Rim soundtrack? What y'all like? Y'all like trip hop? Y'all like trip hop? Cool, cool, cool. Y'all like new age? Double cool, double cool. Y'all like old age? Y'all like Ice Age? Y'all like Ice Age 2 Meltdown? Y'all like trip hop again? Y'all like R&B? Y'all like R&B?
Why don't you come to my house? I've been waiting all that time. Everybody feels lovely in the middle.
Motion. I'm gonna make you breakfast. I'm gonna make you breakfast.
This next song I wrote for my longtime protege Michael Bivins. This song is called Missing You. I wrote this for him to sing on his wedding day. I wrote this for his vows. It's called Missing You. Can I get a penis? Can I get it in my mouth? Can I get a penis? Can I get it up in my mouth? 'Cause girl, I've been missing you. This next track is called, I wrote this for CNC of the CNC Music Factory. I wrote this for CNC. This is called Big Brown Eyes.
Every time I go to the bathroom, I see your face, baby. And I don't know why, I'm looking in the toilet, and I see you looking up at me with those big brown eyes. Brown eyes. Shoot, I seen Tyrone's dick last night. Everybody said he got a big dick. He ain't got no big dick. Shoot, everyone said he got a big dick. Shoot. I don't know what it was. Shoot, everyone said he got a big dick. He ain't got no dick. I don't know what it was. Looked like a half-eaten sausage. I don't know what it was. I mean, I sucked it, but I don't know what it was, though. Shoot. I was at Pinkberry. I was at Pinkberry in Hollywood. Matt Damon came at me like a freak. He presses balls up against the window talking about how you like them apples. I was like, word. Then I was at McDiesel, this nappy ass, grimace looking motherfucker trying to come at me talking about Frenching my fry. I was like, dude, you must be sipping that trip juice. You must be smoking that cocoa butter. Alright, we gotta take it down a notch. Where the birthday girl at? Where the birthday girl at? Where she at? Where the birthday girl at? Where the birthday girl at? Oh, there she go right there. There she go. Hey, y'all, it's her birthday. You trying to hide from me up in the front row? Hey, y'all, it's her birthday. Get up, it's her birthday. Girl. Come on up. You know it's your birthday. You know it's your birthday. You know, bring your stool too. Have a seat, man. Lend yourself that stool. Shoot, you trying to hide from me? You know it's your birthday. What's up, girl?
What's up?
Looking good.
Thanks.
Make a nigga wanna fuck your shit. You know what I'm saying? Make my dick on swole. Make my acorn on wet. Girl, you make my acorn turn into chocolate. Make my butt on bubble. Got my butt all up on bubble. Got my butt cheeks on swelter. You got my penis on testicle. When is your birthday? Now. That's a birthday bash right there. A birthday bash. That's customary. That's R&B customary in a birthday bash. Stomp the glass. When is a fine girl's birthday? Alright, we're about to serenade up in this piece. Happy birthday to you. I'm not gonna touch you. Word. To you, it's your motherfucking birthday. Stick my mother in your girl. That's the end of the song. Thank you for coming up here and participating. You came up here not knowing what to expect, but you came up here anyway. It was a gamble for you to come up here, and you ended up winning. Everybody wins on their birthday. And now, I would like to present the Russian alphabet. A. Asshole. Fuck you, motherfucker. Get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. B. Bitch. Fuck you, bitch. Get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. C. Cocksucker, motherfucker. Get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. D. Do it. Get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. E. E right now. Get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. F. Fuck you. Get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. G. Get out. Get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. H. House. It's mine. Get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. I'm serious. Get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. J. Joking? No, I'm not joking. Get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. K. Kick your ass and do it. Get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. L. Look. Fuck you, get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. And McDonald's, fine, go there, I don't give a shit, just get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. And now, do it now, get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. Oh, alright, get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. P, please. Just get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. Q. Quench on the stand, get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. R, ready or not, get the fuck out of my house. I still hear no shit, get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. T, the fuck out my house, get. U, just get the fuck out of my house. V, fuck you, get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. W, what did I just say? Get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. X, exit the house, get the fuck out of the house. Why? Because fuck you, get the fuck out of my house, motherfucker. Z, zebra. You guys want to participate in an experiment?
No.
Someone say no? Everybody's got to do it. It's not going to work. You guys want to participate in an experiment? The introduction to this experiment is this. Once I was at a comedy club in Scotland, and there was a Scottish comedian on stage whose Scottish accent was so strong that I couldn't understand a single word he was saying. And yet the entire audience was laughing hysterically. I started laughing because to me it was a funny situation that an entire room of people was laughing at something that I couldn't understand a single word of. And so what I'd like to do tonight is I would like to perform for you stand-up comedy using an accent which will make it so that you don't understand what I'm saying. But I want you to laugh anyway. I want you to fake laugh as hard as you can, and my hypothesis is that you will start to genuinely laugh because it will be a funny situation to you that an entire room of people will laugh. Hypothesis that you will start to genuinely laugh because an entire room of people is laughing at something that doesn't make sense. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
All right, I'll make it obvious. It doesn't matter if it makes sense. I'll make it obvious when the punchlines happen, and that's your cue to give it a good, hard, loud laugh. And even in between punchlines, I still want you to sprinkle in organic laughter so that the whole thing feels and sounds real. Got it? All right, you're not going to understand what I'm saying. Laugh anyway. Make it loud, hard, organic, and make it sound realistic, and that's it. You got it? Yeah. Are you ready to collect data?
Yeah.
Keep in mind this is still an experiment. Are you ready to collect data?
Yes.
Woo!
Are you ready?
Yeah.
One more time. Are you ready to collect data?
Yeah.
Here we go. Did guy go out? We did look like a dark bandit, right? Yeah, I look like a dark bandit, right? You know me, I look like a dark bandit. Get the fuck out, you motherfucker! Oh, shut up! Yeah, I look like a dark bandit, right? You go all the way down the plate, you going fitting and doing like that, right? You take going fitting, oh, you going fitting and doing like that, I look like a dog, right? And then I look like a dog, right? Then get the fuck out of here! Oh, shut up. Alright, we're not pretty good with you, right? The previous day I look like a dog, right? Today I look like a tower Brunton. Tower Brunton. He died out of a Tower Brunton. You know, Tower Brunton. Deadwick 1, Deadwick 2, Deadwick 3. What a Deadwick 1 to 5. He died out of a Tower Brunton, right? Now look. The producer said he could have paid a big buck for you to do stand up over John Bunny because he looked like a John Bunny. If the producer could have paid a big buck for you to do stand up over John Bunny, would you do the stand up over John Bunny? You better believe it. What we can conclude from this experiment is three things. One, we can conclude that there are too many unknown variables involved in this experiment to make it valid. So we have to throw out the data. Two, we can conclude that this was much more of an excuse for me to do an impression of my Filipino uncle. And three, we can conclude, based on my personal experience with him and taking my word for it, that he does really look like Charles Bronson from Death Wish 1 through 5. Where are we at on time? Just
out of curiosity.
Okay. All right, fair. Fair, fair.
We're like 30.
Fair, okay. All right, yeah. So five more, I think, right?
Sure.
Sounds good. I mean, whatever, you call the shots.
Whatever you want to do.
Whatever you want to do. What?
You have about 5 more minutes.
How about this, say this. I'm going to say what you want to do, then you say what you want to do to me, and watch this. Ready? What you want to do.
What you want to do.
I want to shoot. Sometimes people criticize me for acting too creepy on stage. What if I act like this?
Sit.
What do you get when you cross a kitten with a puppy? Two meals for the price of one. What's the difference between ice cream and a bucket of seven heads? I don't like ice cream! Hello, miss. How are you?
I'm great, how are you?
You smell well nice.
Meet me in the woods tonight.
You know what the problem with poo-poo is? God made it delicious.
Does that seem less creepy to you? I have one last piece for you tonight. Before I get into it, I'd like to mention that I have a CD for sale. CDs for sale. More than one. This is a relatively new comedy record. It's called Mostly Live. That's the front. And that's the back. And I guess I can set up shop over there and you can get one if you want to. A lot of stuff you didn't see tonight is on this album. And for the stuff, and there's stuff that you did see a little bit. And for that stuff, you can just get this and relive the magic. And for the stuff you didn't see, discover new classics. Either way you win. So get into it. As I mentioned at the beginning of my portion of the show, I don't go to strip clubs. I never have and I never will, because to me, it's frustrating enough looking at a woman with her clothes on. You don't mind me looking at you when I say that, do you? And because I'm naive to the strip club circuit, I once met a stripper, but I had no idea. Our conversation went as follows. Hi, my name is Brent Weinbach. What do you do for a living? I'm a dancer. You mean like tap? No, I'm an exotic dancer. You mean like Buto? And that was the end of our conversation. Now, a lot of people don't know this about me, but I used to be a Buto dancer. And for those of you who don't know what Buto is an ancient Japanese modern dance form. Originally developed in the late 1950s in Berlin, circa 1983. And a third of that is true. It's essentially Japanese modern dance. And I thought that tonight I would end my performance, I would end the show and end the evening with a prepared Buto piece. How about it? This is more of a serious piece, and it is entitled The Bone Collector. And I know you didn't come here to see a serious, dramatic piece, a modern dance piece. I know you came here to laugh. But I just felt like this was a way I could truly express who I am as an artist, and I felt it would be a more artful way to end the show on a more poignant note like this, and that's why I decided to do this. So I think that maybe we won't laugh as much, but we may be able to learn something more about ourselves this way. So now, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, I give you this Japanese modern dance Buto piece entitled The Bone Collector.
At the door they found the first spoke up to leave the soul open. She could tell right away that I was bad at the ball. I had the ball. I had the ball. I had the ball. Woman bed, I make a room steal. I make an old woman blush. I make a room steal. I wanna be yours, pretty baby. Yours and yours alone. Fire. Thank you.
you all have boners. My name is Brent Weinbach. Thank you for listening. Keep it going for Brent!
How do we will not that never gets better? That's the best business that you're gonna make. Twitter, all that stuff. And we'll see you again. We appreciate the support. Thank you so much again to Brandon Kuchin. Good night.